welcome back to the shop. Another boring job to do here today. This caterpillar. Well, this guy's a caterpillar. It's really a Perkins. Engine has been dusted. It's got a real bad brake lamp in it. So, fortunately, there are overbore pistons available for this thing. So, I'm pumping it out 1 millimeter bigger. And let's get this fixed back up and ready to return to service. So, indicated everything square, flat, and true to the crankshaft center line. That took about 2 hours, but finally got it to where it needs to be. And you got it clamped and held. Already done one hole, so you know it's going okay. Back this cutter off 10 thousandths and punch it through there, see how it does. If it looks good, then advance it back to the number, do another one.
Thank you.
Alright, so I should have this job finished up. I got the cylinders all hung. And my dial bore gauge is set to the low end spec. Bores the most, got 2 temps. Temps bigger. Overall bore variance less than 2 temps. So they're all bored within a half a thousandth of the same size. And it'll be a half thousandth bigger than the minimum spec. I'd rather be bigger than the minimum spec than right on minimum spec. If they're too tight, they lock up and they come back. If they're too loose, you never hear about it. So. I mean, if it's too loose, if it's out of spec, then you probably hear about it, but this is pretty much mid-range of the specification that they gave me from out of the book, so I think it's a good place to have it. So, it's ready to go back to the customer. Hope you enjoyed getting to see this little bore in action. Thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, I'll catch you later.